The Matrix 120 is an industrial scanner from Datalogic, which utilizes a 2D imager and an ultra-compact form factor to bring consumers an all-in-one package for track-and-trace manufacturing, label verification, and identification of parts. I will now demo the feature-rich DL.CODE software, which is used to configure the Matrix 120. Once I launch the software and connect my Matrix 120 via USB, I double-check that my user is set to Installer Expert to unlock the full potential of the software suite. I then click and drag my Matrix 120 into the gray box to select it. The details of my device are shown, and I can see that my old configuration is running on this M120. Both the device configuration and presentation mode options are configuration options, but the presentation mode has more options to choose from, so I select presentation mode to start. Right away, my Matrix 120 starts capturing the 2D data matrix codes I printed out. I'll pause the capture for now. The setup has started in automatic mode and already recognized that there are two data matrix codes in its field of view. On the right of the page is an automatic setup option for the camera exposure, but we will do things manually for now. Clicking on the Advanced Setup tab along the top bar gives us manual control over the code settings. Selecting the Image Settings tab gives us access to image quality, lighting, and other camera options. As I increase the exposure time and gain, the sensor will update in real time. I can also manually trigger the scanner to fire once. I experiment with moving the codes around to see where my field of view cuts off and if my focus is okay. Clicking on the DMECC200 tab allows us to customize the options for the code which is captured. This data matrix configuration was automatically added in the first step. Opening the code filter dropdown will let us specify what types of code we want captured by this step. I could filter by code content, but for this demo I will filter the minimum and maximum number of characters stored within the code. I know that one of my code is 20 characters long and the other is 25. When I narrow the range from 1 to 22, I see that one of my code turns red, indicating that it has more than 22 characters. Now, I can add a second data matrix code to my setup and isolate the other code with 25 characters. This time I change the range from 23 to the limit of 3,116 characters. Once I apply the change, I see that I have successfully isolated each code to its own tab. This will allow me to change how I read the codes in the next step. Clicking back and forth between the tabs shows which code is associated with which tab. If I mix the codes and rotate them, the scanner keeps track of which one is which. Right now, my reading phase is set to continuous capture. We will need to tune this. Using the play arrows and pause buttons, let me control the capture while I tweak the settings. If your lighting isn't sufficient to pick up the codes you are scanning, you can utilize image filters to help bring up the contrast or tweak other settings for more successful reads. Our reads are okay, so we will skip this step. Next, we'll move on to the reading phase set up along the top bar. The flowchart that pops up shows us which inputs and outputs are connected. Our Acquisition Trigger tab controls the capture rate of the scanner. It is currently set to continuous, but it can be changed to periodic, delay, or use an external trigger. I will keep it on continuous. Next, I select Phase On from either the left menu or from the flowchart. Here I see the Motion Event checkbox is selected, indicating the scanner will begin looking for codes when it detects any movement. This option can be figured to the COM port or other inputs. I'll leave it on Motion Event and move on to the Phase Off tab. I want the scanner to stop looking for codes once it has successfully found one, so I turn off Motion Event and turn on Success. If the scanner doesn't detect the code in 5 seconds, I want it to stop looking, so I also enable Timeout and set it to 5000 milliseconds. I'll test my setup by pressing the Play button and opening the console. Sliding a code in front of the scanner activates the phase on with motion, and then the phase off when it successfully reads the code, which says Flexible Assembly Systems. If I wave my hand in front of the scanner and activate it and wait 5 seconds, it will stop looking for codes. I slide in my second code, which says Datalogic Matrix 120, and the scanner finds it quickly. When I slide both codes in, the scanner detects them both and outputs both their content to the console. We will customize this data output later. The next step is to determine what a good read is, so we will navigate to the Good Read Setup tab. There are four data collection methods available. Code collection can collect multiple codes before sending a single output. The logic is all set up in the top right box, with options for multi-read and no-read outputs. Code combination outputs depend on if the codes expected are read and meet the logic criteria that is set. Here we expect both codes to be seen. A partial read will result in a no-read, so both codes must be present. Code presentation mode is usually used when codes are manually presented to the scanner. A successful read is sent to the output. There isn't much logic behind this method. Match code will send the codes to the output only if the codes meet the criteria set by the logic. We will use the code combination method for this demo and require both codes to be present for a good read. When I test my configuration and only present one code, the console shows a continuous stream of no reads. When I present both codes, I see them both displayed in the console, but the reading phase isn't turning off on a good read. It seems like changing our data collection method messed up our reading phase, so I will quickly correct this. In the phase off of the reading phase, we had selected success and timeout, but success has changed to good read, so we will re-enable that option. Now when we have a good read, the scanner stops looking for codes until a motion event triggers it back on. Right now, my output is being flooded with no reads, but I am only interested in good reads. I navigate back to the reading phase and select my code combination tab. In the top right, I change the no read option to disabled. Now the only output that should be sent is when a good read has occurred. Let's test it and see what happens. When the scanner detects both codes, a green LED is fired and the output string lists both codes' contents. That is exactly what I want, but this string isn't formatted how I like it. Next, we will format the data output by selecting data formatting along the top bar. In the message 1 field, we see that our output data is sending the code content of expected code 1, then the code content of expected code 2. I'd like to add some space between these two, so I will create a custom field and drag it in between the codes. With the custom field selected, I will edit the string to include a semicolon and a space. When I open the console and test fire, I see that the codes are now separated and easier to read. By using the available modules, I can build an output string of my liking. I'll add another expected code field and set it to output the angle measurement of expected code 1, and then do the same for code 2. Using custom fields, I continue my pattern of separating the data by semicolons and spaces. Now my output shows both codes, followed by the rotation of the codes. This information can be fed to a PLC downstream to control the picking and placing of objects and calculate the rotational offset. Different output channels can be used. USB COM can be used to send outputs over serial, or USB HID to mimic a keyboard entry for notepad or spreadsheet input. If you have a specific outputting format which goes beyond the tools provided, you can create your own JavaScript formats by enabling the script formatter. I will load a preset template for sending all codes to demo its function. When I enable the scanner and I read the codes, the output is determined by the script formatter instead of the software modules. This allows for high-level customization and character substitution that isn't offered through the pre-existing tools. The final page is where you can set up your outputs by customizing the activation and deactivation logic, changing the LED behavior on the scanner, and so forth. Once you are happy with your configuration, you could save it to the PC you are working on, and then save the configuration directly to the scanner device. When saving the configuration, you could set it to be the default configuration upon startup. This concludes our walkthrough of the DL.CODE software and the Matrix 120 industrial scanner from Datalogic. If you enjoyed this video and like to see more like it, please subscribe and enable alerts to be notified when we post a new video. For more information on the Matrix 120 and where to purchase it, check the link in the description below.